When I first met the children of the Sanikzai family in their Durham home, their liveliness despite the confinements of the pandemic surprised me. After moving here in 2017 from Afghanistan, each child has adapted differently to the changes in culture, language, and environment, while still strongly relying on their family as they navigate their journey as refugees in America. Muslima, the oldest of the family at 14, remembers the most of their life in Afghanistan. As she is the first to go through the different levels of the public school system, she takes on the most responsibility within the household and for her academics. But she still takes parts in the jokes by her younger siblings and loves to learn more about pop culture through social media. Fariha, the 5-year-old of the family, skips around the family inside and outside their home, alternating between playing with her dolls and messing with her brother Bassett. Bassett, on the other hand, is rarely seen indoors unless it's snack time. With the other children in the apartment complex, he is always running around on a variety of scooters and participating in pickup games. Salima, the second oldest daughter, acts as the bridge between the younger children and Muslima. She and Muslima both take care of and play with Rana, the newest addition to their family, while simultaneously discussing their lives at school, cracking up about YouTubers, influencers, and TikToks, and watching both old and new Bollywood movies. These include some of their mother's favorite films, which are funnily the only sounds that can stop Rana's crying. Rana, their baby sister born this April amidst the pandemic, is the only child born in America. As the youngest of the household, she is often showered with affection and is active all of the time except for when she is resting. From meeting them to understanding their individual journeys, I have been not only building friendships with them, but also seeing how their lives have varied, yet are similar to other immigrant families. Their home is always bustling with the children, and even in the pandemic, they entertain themselves by fighting and playing with each other, and for the most part, do not cause trouble for their mother. Bassett, the only boy, is often cracking jokes with his sisters. He and Salima fight the most. One minute, they're sharing chocolate chip cookies, then they're fighting over the last piece of candy. Muslima always has one eye on Rana for their mother and makes sure to calm Rana down when she starts to fidget and get upset. Rana usually alternates between peacefully resting in her Afghanese baby wrapping to entertaining her two older sisters. Since tutoring Muslima with her online school assignments, I have noticed the unfair difficulty in completing assignments that require fluent English and cultural references. For an assignment requiring her to pick 10 songs that described 2020, we had to spend a while brainstorming because Muslima mainly listens to Hindi songs and has a limited English discography. Meanwhile, Fariha, who was a baby when they left Afghanistan, is always singing and dancing to the radio version of WAP, while casually throwing out popular memes and jokes with an American accent. While their parents work to build a stable and safe life for their children in this unknown country, hundreds of miles away from the rest of their extended family in Afghanistan, the kids have been adjusting to build a balance for the differences in culture, language, and environment in their daily lives. From adapting and understanding how to fit their Afghanese origins into this new life they were placed into, each child has had varying experiences due to their age, gender, and outlook. Not only do they have different levels of English proficiency and understanding of American culture, but they also have different expectations for their future and nostalgia for their past home. Muslima is unclear on her career goals and interests, but knows she must be able to support her family, while Salima is always cracking jokes about wanting to be a model. But despite it all, they have stayed strong since they first came to America, hopeful, after leaving late one night from Kabul and taking 4 different connecting flights. Each sibling works hard to support each other every step of the way in forging their own paths. This way, they're able to build a new home here in Durham, together, as a family.